We'll be right back. One champion is already crowned, and one more trophy is yet to be handed out here at the Healthy Living Center. T. Cray alongside for this one, St. Boniface Les Rouges, and the CMU Blazers going toe-to-toe here. If you're just joining the broadcast, women's final is in the books, and the St. Boniface Les Rouges continue to reign supreme in women's futsal in the Manitoba College's Athletic Conference. They beat the Bobcats in a thriller. 5-4 was your final earlier today, so St. Boniface has won the title now 5 consecutive times. On the men's side, as we shift gears to that, we got St. Boniface looking for their first championship since 2018. They lost 8-7 at CMU last year in overtime against the Brandon University Bobcats. For CMU, their last title, 2020, right here at the Healthy Living Center when they beat the Brandon Bobcats. So there you go. To recap it, how these two teams got here. The Reds beat the Pilots 4-1 in their semifinal. Four different goal scorers for them. Player of the game, Derek Yappe, scored the game winner for St. B. And then on the other semi, what a finish here. CMU Blazers scoring the winning goal, 3.2 seconds remaining to power their way past the host Bobcats and the two-time defending champion Bobcats by a final score of 4-3.
On behalf of Brandon University, we welcome you to the traditional homelands of the Dakota, Anishinaabeg, Oji-Cree, Cree, Dene, and Métis peoples. And now it's time for your starting lineups! Introducing first from the University St. Boniface Les Rouges, number 4, Abdul Niongadu. Number 7, Amin Morabe. Number 10, Frank India. Number 20, Derek Yappe. And in goal for Les Rouges, Mohamed Fizazi. And now the starting lineup for the CMU Blazers. In goal for the Blazers, number 6, Noah Schindel. Number 10, Victor Hugo Gomez Dabro. Number 13, Matthew Paul. Number 14, Mateus Marino. And number 21, Humayun Umar. Today's referees are Brenna Zeltins and Aubrey Kotelko.
Power. Feel the moment, got me feeling like a lemon head. Put you in the box, just as poison, it's a cigarette. Take on my regards, but regardless, I get arrested. Ain't worried about the killers, just a young and restless. Get mad, cause a $250,000 on my necklace. Do you why I never said I was driving reckless? You and I know the jealousy is not impressive. Oh no, I can't stop, I was destined.
CMU Blazers decked out in green and gold. St. Boniface Les Rouges wearing the white jerseys. Your goalkeepers, it's Noah Schindel for CMU, Mohamed Fizazi for the Reds. Fizazi, I had the opportunity to call that semifinal. That's because I maybe know that game a little bit better because you called it and all, but certainly Fizazi was electrifying between the pipes for Les Rouges yesterday. And Derek Yappe. It was like a human battering ram. He was all over the place and was named player of the game as a result. Things got pretty interesting in the tail end of that game against the Bobcats for CMU yesterday. Less than a minute to go, Camilo Rodriguez scored the tying marker, and you would have thought, you would have bet on it that we were going to overtime. But the Blazers had other ideas and broke the Bobcats' hearts. 3.2 seconds to go. Ishmael Karim got the winner, and that sets up this showdown here right now. During the regular season, It was the Les Rouges winning the first meeting by a final score of 6-2. And then in the second leg, it was a 9-9 draw. The Les Rouges women's futsal team captured the title not too long ago against the host Bobcats by a final score of 5-4. Getting his hands on top of that one, the goalkeeper Noah Schindel. Running time until 2 minutes remaining. Two 25-minute periods here. First time since 2020 that BU's had the chance to host this event. Victor Hugo and company were victorious the last time out here in 2020 when the futsal trophy was all shined up and handed out to the winner. So the Blazers have been here and they've done that. And then for Les Rouges, it was a year ago at CMU. It was Sam Wetstein scoring the overtime winner as the Bobcats made it back-to-back futsal championships in dramatic fashion. 8-7, high-scoring, back-and-forth affair between those two teams. Watch it on our Bobcat YouTube channel. And Westman Communications Group, WCG-TV, continuing to provide outstanding coverage for us. They've been doing it for 30 years now, over 30 years. Got to be closing in on, I would say, 35, 36 years to be exact. Off to the races go the Les Rouges. Are going to get a chance at it. Oh, two great stops by Noah Schindel. Any butterflies that he had, he just squashed them with the left and right foot there, boy. Noah Schindel coming through in the clutch here early with a couple of great saves. Point blank and then one on a nice rebound opportunity for Les Rouges, and it stays scoreless here in this opening period at the Healthy Living Center in the main gym. Normally we go to the old Cats Den for futsal, but hey, when it's championship weekend, you pull out all the stops. And you go under the bright lights here of the main gym. Derek Yappe, there he is, player of the game. Scored the game-winning goal for his St. Boniface Les Rouges yesterday as they defeated the Providence Pilots to get here. That one ricochets off Moreno and it goes out of play. I gotta say, I like the CMU Blazer jerseys because they remind me of Green Bay Packer colors. We got a couple of chop pails down there. A lot of noisemakers out there. If you woke up with a headache this morning, this is not the place to be, I can tell you that much. Really electrifying crowds here the last 2 days. Muhammad Fizazi. Bowling ball action towards his teammate. And the Les Rouges will set things up on offense here. From one side to the other, one side to the other they go. Waiting for the chess pieces to align and they'll go for it here. Across the court and back again. An interception there. Moreno. Traffic by the Blazers gives them the ball back. And there is the electrifying Victor Hugo, number 10. He dished it off. He's got it right on top of the Bobcat logo. Still has it, does Victor Hugo, who has been there and done that. And then there's a goal. And guess who it is? Derek Yappie. And it's so nice that we get to see it twice on the replay. And it just, man, it might have hit Noah Schindel's fingertips along the way. Maybe. But Derek Yappie, who knows? He was the player of the game, and he may very well be your playoff MVP, the way Derek Yappie is playing here. There is Mr. Hugo. Oh, chance for the Blazers. No, it was Fizazzi. Right place, right time to make the stop. Blazers last crowned MCAC Futsal Champs 2020. For Les Rouges, it was 2018. The host, Brandon Bobcats, were champs the last 2 years. Victor Hugo looking to make his move. Threads the needle. Fizazzi again makes a nice save, and it's a two-on-one break the other way, and that one just eludes. Niongadu, Abdul Niongadu. The power's at Derek Yappie's doorstep. Launching that one, sacrificing the body to block the shot was Matthew Paul. Here's another shot and another great stop by Noah Schindel. Schindel keeping his team in this thing here. The Les Rouges striking early on a goal by Derek Yappie. No tiptoeing through the tulip garden for either one of these teams here, with that beautiful trophy hanging in the balance. Noah Schindel dishes it off to Umar, number 21. Now it's with Moreno again. Moreno goes back to the wily old veteran, Victor Hugo. To me, Victor Hugo, he's kind of like the Gordie Howe of the MCAC. Seems like he's been around forever. A header, goes back to midcourt. Trying to keep it in play is Matt Paul. He gains some separation here. Puts the brakes on. Sliding to break that play up. Very nice play defensively was, guess who it is, Derek Yappie. We got a substitution. Ishmael's going to be coming in, number 5. And Ishmael coming in here. He had the winner. 3.2 seconds remaining. So, you know, this guy has got ice water coursing through his veins here. The moment doesn't strike fear into the heart of Ishmael. There he is again, and a nice kick save by Fizazzi. We'll do it all over again with Victor Hugo. Placing it, kicking it. And Fizazzi slipped in the crease area along the way. From one side to the other and back again, trying to cause a commotion is number 14, Moreno of the Blazers. Also up there is 13, Paul. And getting tangled up in the barbed wire there was Ishmael and Randy Gabori. Building that The green monster there in front of the netminder, Noah Schindel. Kick coming up. A block and rebound right there, and I think Schindel got his shin on it to make the stop. Can't clear the zone. Can they now? No, they won't. Another turnover. Belongs to St. Boniface. Heat-seeking missile that smashes another one of the sponsorship wall signs here at the Healthy Living Center. Moreno, Ishmael Karim, Victor Hugo, no. And another sliding stop. Noah Schindel playing his guts out here for his CMU Blazers. Working it back into their own zone. Now getting up and across into Blazers territory, and that one ricochets up into the crowd. And time will continue to run here. That's the thing. You gotta hope that the fans are sitting on springs there and get you the ball back quickly. Amin Mrabeh, number 7, out on the floor for Les Rouges. Some breathing room and a chance to fire, and that was like a meteorite streaking across the prairie sky. That was almost a bullseye with a couple of exclamation points attached to it. Good balance there by Moreno as he accepted that pass out on the ocean waters there on the blue side. Ricochets off and set it all up again. That rolls harmlessly all the way down. Belongs to St. Boniface Les Rouges. Beat the Providence Pilots in the semifinals yesterday, 4-1. For the Blazers, a buzzer beater, 3.2 seconds remaining, off a corner kick to power their way past the Bobcats to get into the championship game. St. Boniface has already got one trophy for the bus ride home. Women's final, 5-4, over the host Bobcats earlier today. Gotta be careful here. Du Les Rouges as the Blazers look to crank it up intensity-wise, getting around that Paul. And Frank and Dia eyes lighting up like a Christmas tree as he fired that one. And just missed the corner post. Ooh, little collision there. And another one. Rocket Ishmael, not afraid to throw the body around here. Doubling back, ooh, that was Moreno. And Axel Adu that get acquainted here. Flipping it up, and right back the other way it goes. Just over 11 minutes to go here in this opening period. Rocket Ishmael. His intended pass up the gut. He's picked up by Les Rouges, but no harm, no foul there. And the Rocket goes back with his teammates in hot pursuit of this, trying to get the game tying goal here. Derek Yappe scored early to give Les Rouges the 1-0 advantage here at the Healthy Living Center. And Noah Schindel's been airtight ever since to keep it. It's a one-goal deficit. Victor Hugo will have it to the Rocket. Here goes Victor Hugo. Hugo got tangled up in the barbed wire. There's a whistle. In their own zone for now are the St. Boniface Les Rouges with Victor Hugo and Paul up front trying to cause a commotion here. That's lobbed nice and high. Schindel puts it down for the Rocket Ishmael. Right down the pipe, easily handled by Fizazzi. Ilias Umar, spine on the pine, number 9 for CMU. Mayan Umar, 21, blocked it. We got another whistle here. Out the situation right now is Victor Hugo. Knows the lay of the land. There's no two ways about that. Does Victor Hugo. Hugo to the Rocket. It's blocked. Maintain possession, Blazers. To Hugo. Hugo fires. And a timeout is called. Recapping it from earlier today, the host Brandon Bobcats got the start they were hoping for against the St. Boniface Les Rouges on the women's side. Bobcats had a 2-0 advantage to start the contest. Momentum just kept swinging from there on out. And 5-4 was your final for St. Boniface to capture yet another women's futsal crown in the MCAC. The first championships were handed out in 2017. And beginning in 2019 and ever since then, the St. Boniface Les Rouges have won it on the women's side. Men's titles. In 23 and 22 belonged to the Bobcats. 2020, Blazers won it. Cats won it again in 19. Les Rouges, they won it back in 2018. St. Boniface got to the championship final last year. 8-7 overtime loss against Brandon University. Sam Wetstein, the Bobcat icon, scored the overtime winner to get the Bobcats another piece of hardware for their trophy case. Lobbing that one up nice and high, and Schindel sees it all the way through. The Rocket. Out of bounds it goes. Intended for Umar, but they ran out of real estate. Derek Yappe, number 20, dishes the Rock. Ricocheting off Ilias Umar. Victor Hugo. And it goes all the way down, but will be a Blazers ball. 8-minute mark, give or take. Derek Yappe's goal so far, the only one of this championship final. Mohamed Fizazzi tests his arm strength, goes all the way down. getting a touch on it, and let's just see here. Nyongadu. Said there was a touch, and he's right on the money to Yappy from the corner, intended for Nyongadu. The Rocket has it in his own zone. Goes out of play. St. Boniface, they're big, they're physical. And a ton of athleticism as well. Trying to get around Victor Hugo. Yappy and Nyongadu in Blazers territory, hoping for a mistake, hoping for a blip on the radar. Here is Victor Hugo. Frank and Dia in him collide. From one side to the other for now. Ilias Umar, a burr in the saddle of the St. Boniface Les Rouges. Lobbing it up, it's there for the taking, kicking it out of harm's way, Mayan Umar. And Hugo put it right in the crease area, and a mistake leads to another goal from Derek Yappy. Right now, it's Derek Yappy's world, and we're still paying rent. Right there, and boom. Good work on the camera. Under 6 minutes to go. The lead is now 2 for the St. Boniface Les Rouges. A turnover at the other side. No harm, no foul, though. And Dia was able to get it out of harm's way. The Rocket. Tangled up with Nyongadu. From the corner. And the Blazers let that one go out of play and they'll reset. Moreno to the Rocket. Backwards started from with Moreno. Ran out of room. Ilias Umar, number 9, and Moreno up front. The header by the Rocket might lead to something good. Oh, a good stop up by Zazzy. A rebound and a goal. M squared, Moreno. Breaking the goose egg on the Blazers' side of the scoreboard. And here's a look at it. Pizazzi making the first stop, the rebound. And we got a 2-1 game here in the MCAC Men's Futsal Championship Final. The suddenness of a lightning strike, it can change in a hurry. The lob shot, a deflection by Moreno. The Rocket dishes it off to Moreno. Back to the Rocket, and the Rocket, oh, they're kind of thinking it hit him up in the hand, hit him up in the forearm area. The ball never lies. 3 minutes to go here in this first period. two unanswered goals by Derek Yappe of the St. Boniface Les Rouges to get things going. And then Moreno replied for CMU. Trying to find the edge is Umar. Fizazi holds it. Lob shot down the middle, seeing it all the way through. Noah Schindel will not take anything for granted. Blazers looking to break out again. It's at his doorstep for Umar. Long shot and sails over the top of Niongadu. Umar Moreno, the rocket with speed. Buck 34 remaining, stoppage time. Corner kick coming up here. Moreno didn't get all of it. Dug his heels in, but not quite. Here's Moreno, he's right up there. He's that burr in the saddle of St. Boniface. Noah Schindel faked it one way, then the other. He's got to go here. Getting tangled up. Physicality here with 1:12 to go in period number one. Then we'll reset a little bit. And then 25 more minutes to go to crown our champion. Gabori took that one high and off the top part of the chest. It's a Rocket and Randy Gabori going toe-to-toe in front of the net of Noah Schindel. 108, that's what it says. Gabori lost the handle on it, and it will be a timeout called. Now, they're always playing good music in here, I can tell you that much. Can't remember who sings this one, but it's like a boss is what it's called. Listen to this song first thing in the morning and be raring to go, be ready to go through a brick wall somewhere. Yeah, this is sadly it. This is the last broadcast that we're going to have for 23-24. And we're in off-season mode. But we'll keep ourselves busy here at BU, Bobcat Awards Banquet, April the 1st. Then we got our charity golf tournament on July the 5th at Wheat City Golf Course. Biggest fundraiser we do. We got to $84,000 last year. And we would love to get to $100,000. Sponsorship packages available, so if you're listening and you might be interested in supporting us, hit me up on the former Twitter, X, at TCraced, and you can get a hold of me there. Ooh. A lot of traffic in front. Wasn't a clear alleyway. And the Rocket fires that one high. These final 2 minutes are always interesting. Mohamed Fizazi keeps it simple. Victor Hugo up front with Ilias Umar. Trying to find the edge now was Gabori, number six, and he's down there in front with him and the Rocket in front of that Blazers cage. Hugo lobbing it up off to the races, Moreno, but beating him to the punch there, Amin Mrabeh. 25.6 remaining on the clock. Moreno. Hugo is lurking in the weeds. Slipping the jab, look out! Right into the bench of the Blazers. And a good display of sportsmanship there between the Rocket and Amin. And not too much either side could have done there. There is going to be a yellow card issued. Guys are going so fast, I'm not sure what else really could have been done there, but maybe there was something down there that I didn't see or hear. But any event, 20.4 seconds to go in the first period. Square off the back. Putting the shield up there was Ilias Umar. Now Moreno. Oh, he just slipped. That looked like it could be a glorious scoring opportunity. 7.5 to go. And we have a player down, and that is Derek Yappe. And Yappe's going to have to sub off here. 7.5 remaining. And the substitution for the Les Rouges. Yappe had both goals for the Reds. It's a gutter war, 2-1. We're at the period break. It's the end of the first half. Derek Yappe's got two goals for St. Boniface. Moreno, the goal scorer for CMU. To take you through the period break here, want to give out a bouquet to Mr. Glenn McNabb, longtime Bobcat men's soccer futsal coach. He's bidding us adieu here at Brandon University. And he's got a long association wearing Bobcat blue and gold. If the jacket still fits, wear it.
I've left this place a few times over my career. To think that this could be the final time as I sail off into the sunset is emotional.
Glenn McNabb first became a Bobcat as a member of the men's hockey team in 1985.
I remember those first tryouts like it was yesterday.
He had a career-high 29 points and was named Most Improved Player in 1986-87.
You got the lineup up there already, Daddy?
Some 30 years would pass before McNabb returned to make an even greater impact.
Brandon University men's soccer? Never in a million years.
He was born and raised in Minnedosa.
I grew up on the farm with a large family. There was five boys in the family, and you started playing hockey to, you know, pass the time in the wintertime. And you know, for us, it was cleaning off the dugout, and my dad built a rink in the in the barnyard.
McNabb played alongside Hall of Famer Ed Belfour with the Winkler Flyers before arriving at Brandon University. After four seasons in blue and gold, McNabb became a teacher and later a principal. He coached hockey at various levels. Then in 2020, he got involved with BU soccer.
What he's left is something that's going to stay at BU forever. He's helped build this culture from top to bottom.
The Bobcats have captured Manitoba College's Athletic Conference Championships under McNabb's guidance. He's been the league's Coach of the Year and led the BU men to nationals twice.
I can still see that, you know, the tenacity and the fireness, especially when it comes to when we're in those big games, whether it's a finals or, you know, a regular season that has the playoff energy. This time there's even a photo here from last year that he shows him up in air and hands all going. So he still definitely still has that athlete in the heart.
Although hockey took up the majority of his playing time, McNabb did have success in high school soccer, winning the 1982-83 provincial title with his hometown Chancellors. He also helped establish a senior men's team in the community.
I mean, if Brandon University had a soccer team back then, it wouldn't have surprised me that I'd have tried out for both the hockey and the soccer team if I could have.
As McNabb bids the Bobcats a final farewell, he knows what he will miss the most.
No matter what you do, it's the relationships that you have with people and the people that you meet.
This is your game. And when you want to stream your game, slow internet won't do. Nay, your game requires the robust speeds of Westman Extreme Internet and enhanced home Wi-Fi. No matter how many devices connect, your HD stream never wavers, and all is right with the world. Stream hockey and other stuff with no waiting. Call or visit Westman online for a great offer today.
Welcome to Brandon University. Come discover your passion as you prepare for a rewarding future career. There are plenty of programs to choose from, with many options in arts, science, education, health studies, and music. At BU, you are an important part of every class. Most courses have 20 students or less, so you develop solid relationships with your professors. You participate in meaningful discussions, and you spark deep connections with new friends. Diversity makes BU a great place to learn. One out of every eight BU students is Indigenous, and we are a longtime leader in providing Indigenous education. We also welcome the world. Nearly 10% of our students hail from outside Canada. And don't forget about the perks of campus life, including great residences, chef-quality meals, and full access to our modern Healthy Living Center, home of the Bobcats. For education, for lifestyle, and for your future, Brandon is your university destination. But don't just take it from us. 98% of recent grads say they recommend BU. Each student earns success we're proud of. Success that is built in Brandon.
All right, 25 more minutes to go here. St. Boniface Les Rouges scored twice. It was Derek Yappe that got both of them. And then Moreno replied for the Blazers to make it 2-1. Just an update as well. A couple of Bobcat-related items to let you know about. Former Bobcat curler, BU Sports Wall of Famer Mike McEwen, and Team Saskatchewan in the Brier semifinals in Regina. And they are leading Alberta by a score of 6-2. McEwen and company got three in the third end. The winner of that semifinal will take on Brad Gushu and Team Canada for the top prize later on tonight. Mike won a National University Curling Championship as a Brandon Bobcat and then represented Team Canada as a Bobcat at the World University Games and won a gold medal. Also, National U Sports Men's Basketball Championship. The hosts Laval Rouge or Cinderella Story. They'll take on Queens in the championship game later on today. The Laval Rouge or are coached by Nathan Grant, former Bobcat men's basketball star. went to the national final as a member of the Brandon University Bobcats. Once upon a time. Victor Hugo dishes and gets it right back again. Ishmael trying to thread the needle, cut through the St. B defenders. Hugo. Moreno lifts it up, and Hugo had it at his feet, still has it, still going, it's out of play, gaining some serious yardage there were the CMU Blazers. Matt Paul lurking in the weeds there, tucked right behind the goalpost there. Moreno. Rocket Ishmael. Moreno back to Victor Hugo. Hugo trying to lift it past the Blazers. Pardon me, the Les Rouges. And a player down. Ishmael in discomfort. I think we got to look at it here on the replay. Let's have a look. Seems to be A-okay. And there was a yellow card issued too, by the way, to St. Boniface on that last play. Well, getting in front of that one, Frank and Dia. There might have been a gap there had he not filled it up there. Another one, ooh, right there on the doorstep. Blazers pushing hard now for the equalizer. Getting tangled up in the barbed wire. Robert dishes on over to Axel Adu. Axel Adu looking to make his move. He's still going with it. A header, and Hugo lost a step. It's right there. Oh, what a play. Noah Schindel races back, leans in, and he is down. Our athletic therapists are earning their stripes here today. Let's take a look at this replay here. And look at that, look at the look in his eyes, and oh man. Oh, right there, I think he stopped. Yeah, I think not intended obviously, but I think he's, Axel Adu stepped right on his hand. Schindel's played really well today, boy. Be interesting to see if he can continue or not. Number 12, Samuel, he is the backup goalkeeper. So Noah Schindel out after making a dramatic stop, boy, let me tell you, he was willing to sacrifice everything on that play. And we're back at it here. This second period just getting started. We still got 22 minutes to go here. Be interesting to see how the Blazers respond to this adversity. Back the other way we go. It's a 2-on-1 the other way, and a good stop by Fizazzi. Moreno, oh, yeah, I think he kind of faked them out there. There's Victor Hugo firing, and it's up and over the top of the crossbar. Matt Paul up front. Victor Hugo as well. Moreno lurking in the weeds. The way down to the other side it goes. They didn't drop into the trash can though. The Rocket tried to go. Young Hugo sets it down for the Rocket. Moreno puts it up there. No dice on that exchange. Throwing it up. So the Blazers have got a new goalkeeper in there. Ooh, careful. Little brain cramp. Oh, it's there. It's in. 3-1. Amin Rabeh. Three to one for the St. Boniface Les Rouges. Victor Hugo trying to thread the needle to the other side for Matt Paul, but to no avail. On their rear ends there, and it's Hugo. Nope, not going to come away with it. Didn't lead to much there. So Derek Yappe scored twice in the first. And Rabez got the other one. Okay, they're one step closer now to the comeback. And I believe it kind of caught me off guard. I believe it was Victor Hugo. And Hugo goes between the legs of the St. B player to score. So they're right back in this thing. Leading into that one, Frank India.
Nirvana, hit me harder again. How deep? deep is your love? Can it go deeper? So tell me, how deep is your love? Can it
how
go
deep is your love?
Noah Schindel made a spectacular diving save, but it was costly. They're going to do it all over again. I do believe this corner kick. Try it again here. Robin has the go-ahead marker right now for St. Boniface. Victor Hugo and Moreno, the goal scorers for the Blazers. Derek Yappe had a couple of them, and he went off in discomfort as well before the end of the first period. He is back out there now, though. That's number 20, Derek Yappe. Heads up. Victor Hugo will place it. Umar races back in hot pursuit for it. 17 minutes to go here in this championship game. Women's final earlier today, St. Boniface Les Rouges, 5-4 winners over the host Brandon Bobcats. Fizazzi made a good stop there too, mid-conversation to myself. And the corner pocket. Precision accuracy, a surgeon's touch. Restoring the two-goal cushioning. Look who it is. Derek Yappe again. Make a statue for Derek Yappe here yet. 16 plus minutes to go here, and Derek Yappe now has a hat trick here for the St. Boniface Les Rouges, as the two-goal lead is restored. Rolling the dice and taking his chances now. Oh, it's there. No stoppage right there. Two green machines swarming Robert. Derek Yappe getting the job done defensively too. And Yappe really kind of the ring general. A yellow card is issued. Frank Ndia threw Matthew Paul into the cage. The human battering ram is out there. Still a lot of miles to go in this one. It could still turn in favor of the Blazers. And St. B's a little bit undisciplined there. Barak and Ishmael. And a header by Ndia to squash any momentum the Blazers were looking to build. 15 minutes now, by golly. Moreno, one of the goal scorers, along with the veteran Victor Hugo. It's with Moreno again. Nyongadu in front of Victor Hugo right now. Here goes Victor Hugo. Out of play. The clock continues to run. But a timeout by Les Rouges. All right, here we go. Out of the timeout, 14:50 to play. Juggle the tad. Bodies are flying all over the place. Victor Hugo and Fizazzi spring loaded to make the stop. No time to celebrate though for Fizazzi and company, even though St. B's got the ball back. Right at midcourt, Derek Yappe. Things stand the way they are now. Yappe's got to be your playoff MVP here from the weekend. Scored the game winner and was the player of the game in yesterday's contest. Ilias Umar. There he is. A one-timer and a good kick save. Here's a look at it on the replay here. Oh. Ouchie. Yappe fires, ricochets off of Moreno. That clock's gonna keep running. Going to keep going and going and going. It's still running here. They're not going to stop it. Time's starting to become of the essence here. That one's gone. That ball, we may never find that one again. Got the garage door open. That could be at the corner of 18th and Vic by now. Marino lets that one go out of play. Ishmael to Ilias Umar. It's high, it's into the St. B bench. Getting to be clobbering time here. We're almost getting into single digits on the score clock. Lobbing that shot up. It was a header by Derek Yappe. Yappe's still going, so got gas in the tank. And Yappe's down as he got tangled up with Victor Hugo. And another yellow card is issued to the CMU Blazers bench. Thank you. So kicks coming up here, and if the Les Rouges find Twine one more time, that may very well do it. Must not be a fan of Home Hardware. Trying to find the edge there, Randy Gabori. Clock still running here. St. Boniface knocking on the door of getting their first Futsal League championship since 2018. Ishmael sends it out of play. Possession arrow goes the Reds' way. Racing out to contend was Ishmael, and it worked for him. Belongs to the Blazers right now. Off the side of the cage. Trying to split the defenders, and a cause is a turnover. And it is, there's it is. There's another one. Make it five now. And it's so nice, we get to see it twice. It was there, and then enough backspin on it, and it goes the St. B way. 5-2 now. Moreno fires it off of Yappy and out of play. So the offense flowing like tap water here right now. Nine minutes and change here. It's all that's left in Final Four weekend. And it looks like, barring an epic comeback, we do know the Blazers have it in them because they did it to the Bobcats yesterday. Scoring with 3.2 seconds remaining. Going Fizazzi's. Right by, oh, Yappy, oh, it's, bodies are flying everywhere. Quick substitution here for the Blazers, who Mayan Umar checks in. Looks like it's going to be a St. Boniface Les Rouges sweep. 5-4 in the women's final earlier today over the host Bobcats. As it stands right now, it's a 5-2 lead right now for the Reds over the Blazers. Yappy blocks a shot by Hugo. Hugo goes through Yappy's legs, but Fizazzi holds down the fort. 8-minute mark. Then we'll have the medal presentations, player of the game announcements, MVP announcements to wrap it all up. Oh, boy. Hugo looking to make his move around Yappy, who is my vote for player of the game and tournament MVP. Maybe Fizazzi, maybe he might be a good one too, maybe for player of the game, and then give Derek Yappy the MVP accolade. Here's Victor Hugo. Oh, and the man looked like a perfect pass, but Paul was just a step or two ahead. In that women's game, I just wanted to just double check here, but it was Marlene Zurichta who was the Final Four MVP. As the St. Boniface Les Rouges scored three unanswered goals, and Zurichta had two of them. As it's a five-peat for the St. Boniface Les Rouges on the women's side. They have been cleaning up at MCAC Women's Futsal. For the men, 5 minutes and change away from their second futsal title in program history, the first one coming in 2018. Racing out to it, there's just four bodies flying all in the same direction. And Victor Hugo alone on the island there. We got a whistle. Umayan Umar swung for the fences on that one. A header. Moreno was there to block the deflection off the header. There's Hugo. Moreno and Fizazzi just calm and cool, throws it down into Blazers territory one more time. Niangadu controls it, has the power at his doorstep. Rabez kick was deflected, so it's his chance to create a little magic here. Strength in numbers back the other way, but doesn't work out on that exchange for St. Boniface Les Rouges. Yeah, Noah Schindel, starting goalkeeper for the CMU Blazers, was injured in a sprawling, dramatic save. And he would be my pick for player of the game, because he had made some real quality stops before that unfortunate injury. And hopefully Noah's doing okay. I thought he really played well for his Blazers. Still 3:51 to go, clock has stopped. And it's, look who it is, Victor Hugo. Hugo Fizazzi. who will rise to the occasion here. This could give the Blazers some momentum. Off the post, a header, and it eludes the Blazers, and Fizazzi is some kind of fired up here with 3:40 to go, and we'll take a look at the replay here. Hugo, just a bender, bang, oh wow, inside part of the crossbar. Low shot, kicked away. The cushion right now for St. Boniface, a comfortable one at 3 goals. Moreno off to the races. We're almost into stoppage time. Throwing it up there. Caught by the Blazers. Ilias Umar. Must go fast. Must rally now. Blazers. That final 2 minutes, though, can crawl by, especially for the team that wants to sip some ginger ale out of that championship trophy. Trophy presentation, medal presentation will follow the final buzzer. And you've been watching it on our Bobcat YouTube channel, but most importantly, Westman Communications Group, WCGTV, been providing all the coverage here this weekend. So I want to give them a nice big round of applause for their efforts here this weekend. They always do a great job for us. And we're going to be leaning on them next spring in March of 2025. When we host the National Men's Volleyball Championship here at Brandon University for U Sports. Bobcats the host team. A deflection, all kinds of traffic in front. Almost at the 2 minute mark, then she's stoppage time. From that point in, point out, Moreno up top to the Rocket Ishmael, back over to Moreno. Extra attacker. Victor Hugo, race back. Corner kick coming up for St. Boniface. Leaning into that one, a block. Another chance at it. Hugo rolls it to Moreno. Time winding down here in this Manitoba College's Athletic Conference Men's Futsal Championship Final. St. Boniface Les Rouges women's team completing the five-peat. St. B men. Right there to claim their first title since 2018. Rolls all the way down, so they'll stop it. Batting down the hatches here are the St. Boniface Les Rouges. Moreno, Hugo lost it. 1:19 to go. Flop shot. Moreno dishes to Hugo, back to Moreno. Now Ishmael, that one blocked and clearing it out of there. In some discomfort is Frank India, but he appears to be A-OK. Fizazi holds it with 1:03 to go, heaves it up there. It's out of play again. Officially under 1 minute. Les Rouges just leaning hard here in these final couple of seconds. Not willing to lean on the shovels just yet. .8 to go. Victor Hugo, Moreno up top on the Bobcat logo. Slides it over to the Rocket Ishmael. Here's Hugo. Oh, that was close, a deflection along the way. Matt Paul almost knocked it in. Here's Moreno with a heat-seeking missile, leaving a vapor trail behind it. 17.4 to go. They got the drums going. The St. Boniface Les Rouges have been very comfortable here in the main gym under the bright lights at the Healthy Living Center. Under 10 to go now. That one hits pretty much everything along the way. Hugo lobs it up, too far, 3.4. Moreno off of Yappy, and they're in celebration mode. The St. Boniface Les Rouges reign supreme at the Healthy Living Center. The final 5-2. And for the first time since 2018, the St. Boniface Les Rouges rule the Manitoba College's Athletic Conference in men's futsal. We will have the trophy presentation, player of the game announcement, your playoff MVP announcement, all coming up here shortly. So I'm going to throw it downstairs. If you want, I can hang around or I can just sign off and can let the sights and sounds of our PA announcer carry you the rest of the way. Thanks everybody for your support of the Manitoba College's Athletic Conference and Brandon University Athletics as well. Congratulations, the St. Boniface Les Rouges win not just one, but two championships here today. The women's team beat the host Bobcats 5-4. The men's team over the CMU Blazers here just moments ago.
Living in a lonely world, he took the midnight train.
We'll now ask that players line up for the Player of the Game presentations. To present the awards today is Thomas Friesen of the Brandon Sun. We'll start first with the CMU Blazers Player of the Game, presented by the winning 11 Player of the Game. For the CMU Blazers, the Player of the Game is number 14, Mateus Mourinho. And now it's time for the winning 11 Player of the Game for the USB Les Rouges. Today's Player of the Game in goal, Mohamed Fizazi. Winning 11 is an online soccer shop selling soccer merchandise such as jerseys, soccer accessories, and customized jerseys. To learn more, visit at MBWinning11 on Instagram. And now it's time for the MVP of the MCAC Futsal Men's Tournament. And that belongs to the USB Les Rouges number 20, Derek Yappe. And now we will have our medal presentations for the champion, the MCAC Futsal Final Four, the USB Les Rouges. We'll start now our award presentations. Number 4, Abdul Niongadu. Number 5, Kwasi Brandon Curtis Delore. Number 6, Randy Gabori. Number 7, Amin Morabe. Number 8, Yusuf Kawi. Number 9, Anwar Chawab. Number 10, Frank Nidia. Number 11, Asel Adu. Number 16, Philip Sona. Number 19, Hamad Awal Joye. Number 20, Derek Yappe. Number 22, Elmadi Eruruziz. Number 23, Mofini Fulua Familusi. Number 30, Kofi Chen Yan Emmanuel Taki. And in goal, Mohamed Fizazi. And also in goal, Ayub Hilmi. Head coach for the USB Les Rouges, Saif Dawi. Assistant coach, Yahia Shihab. And assistant coach, Ibrahim Bizau. Congratulations once again going out to the USB Les Rouges. We'll now call forward the captains to be presented with the banner and the MCAC Futsal Final Four trophy.